We are all about the preservation and education and use of wooden canoes. Once a year we gather all our members that would come to a single four-day event held in different parts of the country each year. This is our 31st gathering. There are multiple components. There's really something here for everybody who enjoys anything about boating, canoes, or wooden canoes, or anything wood. There are assembly tents. You can hear a little tapping in the background where we talk about construction issues. There are a lot of vendors here that have items for sale for canoes, many times older parts that are harder to find. We also have canoes on display, so members can sell canoes here, or they can just display canoes, and you'd be amazed how easy it is to talk about your canoe and how many people want to hear what you have to say about your canoe.
One would think that as a canoe builder I come here as work, but it isn't. It's a big holiday for all of us, and these are my friends that I see once a year. They're my canoe friends, and it's just a big, happy, wonderful reunion. And even though I've been building canoes for 20 years, and you know, people will come by and they'll say, "Oh, I read that article, Pam, you wrote in the journal about painting," and they'll want more information, and I just, you know, you just share everything here.
This piece of wood, nice and square, is almost 1 inch, so you'd steam it about an hour.
The workshops are everything from how to restore old canoes to building new canoes. The instructors are very, very talented, very good woodworkers, painters, leather people. It's a really unique group. So depending upon where you go off to in the learning tents or reconstruction tents, there's an awful lot of information you can learn and obtain.
14 years ago, I had purchased my first wood canvas canoe. It was a restoration project that needed a lot of work, and I met a person through a local canoe shop that recommended this organization. So I came to my first assembly then to try and figure out what do I do to restore this boat to its original condition, and so I've been coming back ever since.
We exchange a lot of information between ourselves. And the organization's a little bit unique in that the people that do this for a living are more than willing to share their time and their talent with you to answer questions, so you can learn from the best when you come up here to assembly.
I'll go up to the construction tent and I'll see another builder doing something that I've done one way for 20 years, and it's like, oh my goodness, that's such a good idea. You know, why didn't I think of that before? So I always learn something as well when I'm here, and it's a real treat. You'll never see another place with so many wooden canoes all on one lawn any place. This is the big event for sure.
There's a lot of different styles of construction that are here, even though they're all maybe pretty similar looking. If you really look at some of the fine details, people have different interpretations as the way some of the wood should be going together, and it's pretty fascinating.
The shape of the hull changes. It's different than a lot of conventional boats today. Some have keels, some don't have keels. It might alter the paddling characteristics of the boat a little bit. But and canoes are just as different as anything else. Cars, trucks, planes. Yeah. To the average person, probably a canoe is a canoe, but there's a lot of different types of canoe.
This one is named the Mary Betts. This one was actually built in 1996, so it's very new compared to most of the canoes here on display. This is called a courting canoe, and it's a courting canoe because it has these long decks that minimize how many people can fit in this canoe. And there are a couple of different reasons that they did this, and part of the reason they put on these long decks is that it was a fancier canoe with that type of finish, including things like the fancy paint job. So they became kind of the, I'll call it the Duesenberg or the Cadillac or the Mercedes, whatever, the high end of the canoeing scene. Wooden canoes are solid, and there's just something very, substantial about paddling a wooden canoe. There's something about the gleam of the varnished surfaces and the sunshine and other things that just make it something that no other material, canoes made of other materials, just can't compare. And they track well, and I just always feel special when I'm in a wooden canoe. Doesn't have to be one this fancy. Any wooden canoe feels great in the water and way different from aluminum or some of the new modern materials.
Wooden canoes just sit in the water differently. They're quiet, they're warm, they're just incredibly beautiful. So if you love canoes, you can't help but love a wooden canoe. They're very special. Often you'll go out the first thing in the morning and before you've had breakfast when the sun's coming up and the mist is on the lake and, you know, there's the loon in the bay and, oh my goodness, it's just, you know, it doesn't get any better than that. You know, and you can get into little ponds and lakes that you can't get to with a motorboat or whatever, and then you're going to see the otters and you're going to see the, you know, the muskrats and all those little critters out there. It's the heron in the reeds. So yeah, there's something that's so wonderful about just being able to paddle, you know, nice and quietly and right along the shoreline, because they're not deep, and you see so much early in the morning or just in the evening. They're pretty special.